What do you think an ICU nurse is making salary-wise per year? Well, in this video, I'm gonna talk all about that, so keep watching. My name is Christine, and welcome to your new video. If it's your first time here and you wanna become a CRNA or grow your CRNA career, start now by subscribing and hitting the bell so you don't miss any information. When you're thinking about critical care nursing, it's the same exact route to become a critical care nurse versus many different specialties that you're thinking about going into in registered nursing. You still need to get your degree in nursing. So for example, there's different levels of nursing. Of course, there's LPN, of course, there's registered nurses. You can be a registered nurse, but have an associate's versus a bachelor's degree in nursing. As well as when you are a bachelor, you have a bachelor's degree in nursing, then you have to take your certification board exam, which is an NCLEX, and that allows you to be a registered nurse. And you can work in many different specialties out there. Now, thinking about critical care nursing and intensive care nursing, some hospitals, depending on the hospital and the institution, you may be required to get 6 months to a year of training in another specialty, for example, medical surgical unit, where you're on a general floor and you're getting a wide range of experience. And then they say, okay, then you can apply to become an ICU nurse. And then you get accepted, and then now you have that experience. Now, that is in general, but there are some ways you can get into the ICU right after you graduate your nursing degree. You can get into something called a nurse residency program, where you can apply as a graduating nurse with no experience, get accepted into a teaching institution, maybe a trauma institution, or even a veterans hospital through the government. They do accept, depending on the specific hospital and institution, you can get accepted to go right into the ICU and get your training right away. So that's definitely a route that you can do to become an ICU nurse. Now, when you think about ICU nursing in general, you are a registered nurse. So when I've done some videos on registered nursing, click the link above to go all about that, as well as advanced practice nursing salaries, click the link above. There's a ton of data out there with salaries, and I've looked through all of the data for you today, and I'm just gonna give you the estimations, because of course, depending on the sources, depending on the sample size, depending on, of course, the website, as well as the Bureau of Labor and Statistics, there definitely is a little bit of variation. But in general, streamlining it, there's a general commonality what I've seen in the data to give you that information about ICU nursing and what you're gonna get as an ICU nurse. Now, you gotta think about this too. Yes, you might be an ICU nurse and you'll be thinking, well, am I gonna get paid more? In general, you're not gonna get paid as much more as a regular nurse on the floor. Depending on if you get your certification, your CCRN, usually with most hospitals, they will actually allow you to get a higher salary because of that. They'll actually give you money because you got your certification. So it'll give you a higher tier in your salary, as well as years of experience. With some hospitals, the more years of experience, you're gonna get paid a higher salary because you have that experience. You're more of an expert in nursing. So let's get into a little bit more information about critical care nursing. So as a registered nurse first, let's get into that. You're gonna be making approximately $75,000 a year, plus or minus, okay? Depending on the state, depending on the region you're looking at to work, okay? Teaching institution versus more of a smaller institution. That always varies. You will get paid a general amount, that there's an annual median salary looking at the data, but depending where you work, you may get paid less or more. Critical care nursing, when you're looking into that profession, sometimes it's about the same. It's about $75,000, but in some cases, looking at the research, it can be up to $80,000 a year, because it's more of a specialty. So, and also depending on the specific institution you're looking at, also it's looking at if you're a traveler, because in general, ICU is known for a high turnover rate, as well as people get burnt out, and it could be very difficult. So there's a lot of shortages in nursing in general, and that's one of the areas that there's a high shortage in nursing. So in general, if you were to do travel nursing, you can get paid well above $80,000, $90,000, $100,000 a year just for traveling to an institution. So those are definitely opportunities you can look at. So in critical care nursing in general, it's about $80,000+ a year, which is about $5,000 more. But in some hospitals, they will not pay you any difference compared to labor and delivery, or neonatal ICU, or if you're doing a regular pediatric floor, oncology. They'll pay you, everyone in an institution get a flat salary. And of course, when you're looking at years of experience, as well as if you have certifications under your belt, if you're a nurse clinician, as another tier of a staff nurse, you know, you've gone back and got more education and some research and try to help out with quality improvement measures on your floor. So they will get you a little bit paid, you will get paid a little bit more, but in general, it's about the same as the registered nursing job and ICU nurse, just a different sector of it. So you'll be approximately getting paid about that. Now, when you're looking at different states, there are some states that are paying definitely about $50,000 a year, whereas there are some other states that are paying close to $100,000 a year. Looking at California, California is one of the states that are paying very high. You can make the annual median salary for a registered nurse in California is about $106,000, $106,000 a year. And California is known to being the top paying state for registered nursing. So definitely take that into consideration when you're looking at different states as well as different hospitals. And that will definitely help guide you on that information. Another recommendation, so saying, for example, if I have CRNA, yes, you're saying these salaries, but where can I find jobs? Where can I look to get that data? I definitely recommend looking at Indeed.com. That's an area where you can get this. When you look at that website, it definitely can give you different state-specific job opportunities that you can look at as a new grad or a registered nurse who wants to switch into a different degree. So definitely look into that. Also, Career Builder website, as well as Simply Hired. Now, just giving you some little bit of information, those are the top websites to find jobs online for nursing. But there are differences I've noticed with those different websites when you're looking at job opportunities, okay? So let me give you that information. That's a bonus information that I think you need to know. Looking at the data in general, I'm just giving you general numbers that I've looked at and I've seen. It's showing that Indeed.com are giving, you know, looking at the data, there are more opportunities and job opportunities with higher salaries compared to Simplified. You're getting more $55,000 a year, like showing that what kind of job opportunities are available to you. But the higher paying one is that showing job opportunities is Career Builder. Okay, that's where I've seen about $83,000 a year you can be a registered nurse finding jobs in that search engine. However, you know, depending on you, I definitely keep your options open. Look at different websites and see what salaries are opportunities for you. As well as, of course, when you go for your interview, you can always negotiate, okay? And always negotiate your salary. You should just never say, I'm okay with that salary you're offering me. Say, hey, I have these things on my application, these things on my resume. It allows me to stand at a higher salary range, okay? So I hope this helped you. If you want to learn more about CRNAs and how to grow your CRNA, definitely click one of these videos over here, and I'll see you in the next video.